Dr. Dharani, I actually wanted to ask you, why is protein essential in the current scenario?
See, protein is important always for the life growth itself. Starting from an infant who takes mother's milk to 6 to 12 months where we give other foods and mother's milk. Then after 1 year, we introduce other types of milk like cow's milk and all that. And it's very, very important because from 2 to 5, the children, though they are growing lesser than from 6 months to 12 months, their growth is still happening, their height is happening, muscle is growing. And the next most important phase would be adolescence, where between 10 and 15 to 16, the girls are growing, and the boys are growing between 12 and 16 to 18. So the growth spurt can happen at any time. So it's important to give them extra protein for muscle growth, for bone growth and all organ growth. Every tissue is made of protein. So organ growth or skin growth or hair growth or muscle growth needs protein. And then we move on to in a woman, pregnancy and lactation, which is very, very important because the growth of the baby depends on the amount of protein the mother takes. And if the mother doesn't take enough protein, automatically her muscle will be broken down, which is not good for her health because then her immunity can go down. So when we look at the life cycle, elders need 60 plus, they all need protein to fight the immunity. And hence, every stage of life, protein is very important. It's important for hair growth, nail growth, for everything, for your organ to work regularly properly. And if you take even hemoglobin, heme and globin, heme is iron, globin is protein. So if you have deficient protein, your hemoglobin could be less, which actually interferes with transferring even oxygen to every part of the body, even to the brain. And also all nutrients are transported through the blood to the body. So hemoglobin is very important and we need to take protein regularly on a daily basis to make up the protein need.
And could you highlight some of the key benefits that are there across some generic benefits of protein?
Yeah, so coming to protein, it starts with basic growth that is needed. Second, everybody thinks it's only muscle. Muscle growth is there, bone is also needed. Next is it helps you fight immunity because the first line of cells which fight immunity are the white blood cells which create antibodies. So that is made of protein. So we need that. And all your enzymes are protein. So for your body functions, we need protein. And for your eyes, for you to see at every minute, the action that is happening, that needs protein. And for you to walk, you need energy, but you also need protein. That is why those who do extra exercise, we tell them to take more protein. And so protein is needed at every aspect of life, from breathing to growing, to when you grow old, to rejuvenate your body, because we're losing skin cells every day. The hair is actually, we are losing so much of it every day. And we don't know how much more is lost within the body. So protein is needed for everything.
Sure. I also, I am really happy to tell you that I have Jersey as a brand.
Yeah, I can't hear you.
Can you hear
me? They are not audible.
Yeah, now it's fine.
Yeah. Okay. So I also wanted to, as you're aware that we, Jersey has launched a protein milk, protein plus stone milk. Dr. Dharani, Jersey has launched as a brand of protein plus stone milk, which has higher amount of protein. How do you think the protein milk is essential in the current scenario? An enhanced product with increased amount of protein can help.
Yeah, in our dietary surveys, we find that everybody is not eating enough protein. The ICMR, that is the Indian Council of Medical Research, has given India the recommended daily allowance of protein which is 1 gram per kg, which is ideal body weight. So somebody is like 160 centimeters, their ideal body weight is anything from 58 to 62 kilos, and they have to eat a minimum of 60 grams of protein. But what they are actually eating is only 20 to 30 grams. The recommendation for milk is 400 to 500 ml per day, either as milk or curd, so milk products basically. But what we see people are eating, a four-member family are buying only 250 ml.